Oh, shit talking kitty.
He's heading the home.
So you're 70.
I'll be 75 in May.
75, okay.
So yeah.
Young spring chicken.
Getting on, getting along.
My birthday's the 9th of May.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Mine's 15.
Oh, that's Carolyn's mum's. Oh, 13th. And her sister's.
At my spiritual mum's house, guys.
I'm gonna clean some windows now. Okay, I'm cleaning the next one. Okay, done that one and that one. I'm about to do this one now. Actually, I might not do this room. It's too tricky because of the bed and everything. So, because of the bed and all that. So, and there's a whole lot of other things shoved in the window. Whoops. So, I'm helping my spiritual mum because she's moving house. And the house is going to be on the market. So, I'm helping her out as a disciple of Jesus. And me as a crazy idiot who's been stupid. Been cheeky. So I might, that's better. I think I might do this room instead. I found a perfect spot for the phone. Alright, that'll do it for now. Like and subscribe to Oshi Talking Kitties and also hit the notification bell so that way you don't miss out on my shows. I'm going to continue on. It's going to take most of the day. It's a big house. I'll let you go. Stay safe. God bless you.
She says, then his sister asked Pharaoh's daughter, shall I go and get one of the Hebrew women to nurse the baby for you? Yes, go, she answered. So the girl went and got the baby's mother. Pharaoh's daughter said to her, take this baby and nurse him for me, and I will pay you. So the woman took the baby and nursed him. When the child grew older, she took him to Pharaoh's daughter, and he became her son. She named him Moses, saying, I drew him out of the water. One day, after Moses had grown up, he went out to where his own people were and watched them at their hard labor. He saw an Egyptian beating a Hebrew, one of his own people. Looking this way and that, and seeing no one, he killed the Egyptian and hid him in the sand.
Oh.
The next day he went out and saw two Hebrews fighting. He asked the man in the wrong, why are you hitting your fellow Hebrew? The man said, who made you ruler and judge over us? Are you thinking of killing me as you killed the Egyptian? Then Moses was afraid and thought, what I did must have become known. When Pharaoh heard of this, he tried to kill Moses. fled from Pharaoh and went to live in
Boston,
where he sat down by the well. Now the priest of Midian had 7 daughters, and they came to draw water and fill their troughs to water their father's flock. Some shepherds came along and drove them away, but Moses got up and came to their rescue and watered their flock. When the girls returned,
tell you what, guys, I can be a crummy cleaner.
Asked them, why have you returned so early today?
Doesn't matter.
They answered, an Egyptian rescued us from the shepherds. He even drew water for us and watered the flock.
Sweat like a pig.
His daughters, why did you leave him? Invite him to have something to eat. Moses agreed to stay with the man, who gave his daughter Zipporah to Moses in marriage. Zipporah gave birth to a son, and Moses named him Gershon, saying, I have become a father.
It's my favorite room, the sun room.
During that long period, the king of Egypt died. The Israelites groaned in their slavery and cried out, and their cry for help because of their slavery went up to God. God heard their groaning, and he remembered his promise to Isaac and with Jacob. So God looked on the Israelites and was concerned about them.
God looked on the Israelites.
Exodus chapter 3. Now Moses was tending the flock of Jethro, his father-in-law, the priest of Midian. And he led the flock to the far side of the wilderness and came to Horeb, the mountain of God. There the angel of the Lord appeared to him in flames of fire from within a bush. Moses saw that though the bush was on fire, it did not burn up. So Moses thought, I will go over and see this strange sight, why the bush does not burn up. When the Lord saw that he had gone over to look, God called to him from within the bush, Moses, Moses. And Moses said,
must be outside.
Here I am. Do not come any closer, God said.
God said, do not come any closer.
To the place where you are.
Or Nick will die. I'm just being stupid.
Then he said, I am the God of your father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. At this, Moses hid his face because he was afraid to look at God. The Lord said, I have indeed seen the misery of my people.
Yeah, the people of Israel. Oh my God. That's probably why they were there.
To rescue them from the hand of the Egyptians and to bring them up out of that land into a good and spacious land. A land flowing with milk and honey. The home of the Canaanites.
I'm just getting the finger marks off.
Amorites, Perizzites, Hivites, and Jebusites. And now the cry of the Israelites has reached me. And I have seen the way the Egyptians are oppressing them. So now, go. I am sending you to Pharaoh to bring my people, the Israelites, out of Egypt. But Moses said to God, who am I that I should go to Pharaoh and bring the Israelites out of Egypt? And God said, I will be with you. And this will be the sign to you that it is I who have sent you. When you have brought the people out of Egypt, you will worship God on this mountain. Moses said to God, suppose I go to the Israelites and say to them, the God of your fathers has sent me to you, and they ask me, what is his name? Then I tell them. God said to Moses, I am who I am. This is what you are to say to the Israelites. I am has sent me to you. God also said to Moses, say to the Israelites, the Lord, the God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, has sent me to you. This is my name forever, the name you shall call me from generation to generation.
Oh, that's amazing.
Assemble the
elders of Israel
and say to them, the Lord, the God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob appeared to me and said, I have watched over you and have seen what has been done to you in Egypt. And I have promised to bring you up out of your misery in Egypt, into the land of the Canaanites, Hittites, Amorites, Perizzites, Hivites, purring with milk and honey. The elders of Israel will listen to you. Then you and the elders are to go to the king of Egypt and say to him, "The Lord, the God of the Hebrews, has met with us. Let us take a 3-day journey into the wilderness to offer sacrifices to the Lord our God. But I know that the king of Egypt will not let you go unless a mighty hand compels him. So I will stretch out my hand and strike the Egyptians with all the wonders that I will perform among them. After that, he will let you go. And I will
let the Egyptians
favorably disposed towards his people.
This is what I'm doing. That and that.
Every woman has to ask her neighbor and any woman living in her house for articles of silver and gold and for clothing that you will put on your sons and daughters, and so you will plunder the Egyptians." Exodus chapter 4. Moses answered, "What if they do not believe me or listen to me and say, 'The Lord did not appear to you'?" Then the Lord said to him, "What is that in your hand?" "A staff," he replied. The Lord said, "Throw it on the ground." Moses threw it on the ground, and it became a snake, and he ran from it. Then the Lord said to him, "Reach out your hand and take it by the tail." So Moses reached out and took hold of the snake, and it turned back into a staff in his hand. "This," said the Lord, "is so that they may believe that the Lord, the God of their fathers, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, has appeared to you." Then the Lord said, "Put your hand inside your cloak." So Moses put his hand into his cloak, and when he took it out, the skin was leprous. It had become as white as snow. Now put it back into your
cloak. Trying to get rid of cobwebs at the same time.
So Moses put his hand back into his cloak, and when he took it out, it was restored like the rest of his flesh. Then the Lord said, "If they do not believe you, or pay attention to the first sign, they may believe the second. But if they do not believe these two signs or listen to you, take some water from the Nile and pour it on the dry ground. The water you take from the river will become blood on the ground." Moses said to the Lord, "Pardon your servant, Lord. I have never been eloquent, neither in the past nor since you have spoken to your servant. I am slow of speech and tongue." The Lord said to him, "Who gave human beings their mouths? Who makes them deaf or mute? Who gives them sight or makes them blind? Is it not I, the Lord? Now go, I will help you speak and will teach you what to say." But Moses said, "Pardon your servant, Lord. Please send someone else." Then the Lord's anger burned against Moses, and he said, "What about your brother, Aaron the Levite? I know he can speak well. He is already on his way to meet you, and he will be glad to see you. You shall speak to him and put words in his mouth. I will help both of you speak and will teach you what to do. He will speak to the people for you, and it will be as if he were your mouth, and as if you were God to him. But take this staff in your hand so that you can perform the signs with it." Then Moses went back to Jethro, his father-in-law, and said to him, "Let me return to my own people in Egypt to see if any of them are still alive." Jethro said, "Go, and I wish you well." Now the Lord had said to Moses in Midian, "Go back to Egypt, for all those who wanted to kill you are there." So Moses took his wife and sons, put them on a donkey, and started back to Egypt. And he took the staff of God in his hand. The Lord said to Moses, "When you return to Egypt, see that you perform before Pharaoh all the wonders give power to do. But I will harden his heart so that he will not let the people go. Then say to Pharaoh,
not let my people go.
Israel is my firstborn son, and I told you, let my son go so that he may worship me. But you refuse to let him go, so I will kill your firstborn son. At a lodging place on the way, the Lord met Moses and was about to kill him. But Zipporah took her flint knife, cut off her son's foreskin, and touched Moses' feet with it. Surely you are a bridegroom of blood to me, she said. So the Lord let him alone. At that time, she said, bridegroom of blood, referring to circumcision. The Lord said to Aaron, go into the wilderness to meet Moses. So he met Moses at the mountain of God and kissed him. Then Moses told Aaron everything the Lord had sent him to say, and also about all the signs he had commanded him to perform. Moses and Aaron brought a
I'm going to wash the outside windows now, guys. I've done that summary. Look at that.
Eleazar and Ithamar. The sons of Korah were Asa. These were the
Korah
sons. Eleazar, son of Aaron, married one of the daughters of Judah.
I don't know if you can... Oh, jeez. Let's go check. Aye, good. So I've got to do this window and that window. So I might stick the phone here for now. Trying to get rid of cobwebs. Yeah, I had a funny feeling I was going to do this. I knew it. I was waiting for it. All good. We're going to have a beautiful salad bowl for lunch. Cobwebs. Trying to get rid of bird poop. Okay. I'm aiming it that way so it doesn't spray back towards there. Stay. Thank you. Sorry if I'm a crummy cleaner.
No, it's alright. It'll be alright.
Well, how have I done so far?
Well, I think that is good. You can never tell with windows until the morning when the sun's shining.
I know, and you get all this smear rubbish.
Streaking.
Oh, it's horrible.
I'm not worried about it.
Well, they're going to get dirty again. Way before you better to do them properly when you actually have sold the place.
Yeah, when I'm moving
out. I can't even open this fly screen, I'm going to have to leave it. Oh, hang on, here it is. Hang on. Thank you.
Next window, people.
Next one.
I just gave it a bit of a top up because it was getting empty, so I just tipped some from the other one that my spiritual mum gave. I mean, had for her part. Back at work, people. Hey, now she's working. Might use a different cloth. Dang it. Whew. Got myself. Gosh, dang it. I'm not going to get too fussy with that one. Thank you. You're blowing me over. I'm getting blown away by you.
Deaf old thing.
Susie,
yeah.
I'm getting blown away by you. I've been washing all the bird poo away too.
Cool.
I'm fully sick.
Fully sick.
Eh?
Fully sick.
Yeah, bro. Sis. I nearly said bro then. I'm a bit of an idiot, don't worry. I love being an idiot.
Lucky last, the door.
Yo!
While I'm away, can you do the outside of those two small windows inside?
Oh, where those doors are?
Yeah.
Alright.
I think you can reach those.
Yep, alright.
Okay. And I've got some eggs on, so...
Maybe put them on low in case I forget.
Yeah, that's alright. I've got them on low.
How I'll clean those windows? I'll just spit on them. She knows I'm an idiot. Okay, scrap that out. This was going to be lucky last. I've still got windows to do. Gotcha. Cobwebs. This place is going to look good when it's in the market. Good catch. Oh, now I have to do these other windows.
When the Lord goes through the land to strike down the Egyptians, he will see the blood on the top and sides of the door frame and will pass over that doorway. And he will not permit the destroyer to enter your houses and strike you down. Obey these instructions as a lasting ordinance for you and your descendants.
For the salad rolls.
When you enter the land that the Lord will give you as he promised, observe this ceremony. And when your children ask you, what does this ceremony mean to you? Then tell them, it is the passing of the sacrifice.
Well,
I can swear now she's gone. Just kidding. Shouldn't swear at all, but
oh, that happens.
That's fine. I'm getting so old. Really, that's inside? I went over all that. Oh, you mongrel. Heavens knows where he went. I'm gonna check something. Stay there, phone. Oh, guys. I had to use my nail to get all that muck off. It looked like nail polish or something, so I had to use my nail to get it off. It's all gone now. So that's it for the day, guys. Like and subscribe to Oshitalkin Kitties and hit the notification bell too, so that way you don't miss every show that I've do. So whether it's skits or YouTube vlogs or home entertainment, this is what you call home entertainment. So I do more than just skits. I haven't done it for a while. I've been a bit slack, but might do it one day. So I'm helping my godmother out. As much as my crazy cheeky humour, she deals with it. You all have a great day. Stay safe. God bless you. And like and subscribe. Enjoy the show.